The inquest began with the names and faces of those who died shown to the court. One by one, 50 names were read as a sign of respect.
St Basil's experienced the worst outbreak of the deadly coronavirus that swept through Victoria's nursing homes during what is referred to as the second wave of community transmission.
Christine Golding's 84-year-old mother, Efraxia Saldaniris, died in August last year. She says today is all about telling the stories of their loved ones.
I wanted the true story told about what happened at St Basil's, what happened to our loved ones, the suffering, the neglect that they experienced. So I want the truth to be told.
The first case at St Basil's was detected on July the 9th, but the court was told the aged care facility notified the Victorian Department of Health and Human Services 8 days later. Dr Ian Norton, an expert in disaster and emergency health responses, has provided an independent report to the inquest, and he found this delay led to the subsequent outbreak.
He describes this delay of 8 days as, quote, the root cause of a serious outbreak not being contained and the subsequent issues faced at St Basil's, end quote.
Following the outbreak at St Basil's, Victorian Chief Health Officer Brett Sutton deemed that staff were close contacts and were to be furloughed. In his statement, Professor Sutton said the decision was based on the best health interests for both residents and staff.
But Ms Golding says it meant staff who were unknown to the residents would be brought in. She says one nurse told her, if all the staff go home, then people will die, not of COVID, but neglect. And once I'm gone, I can't guarantee the safety of your mother. Ms Golding says she felt like she'd been punched in the guts and a sense of impending doom. The hearing was told once the Commonwealth took over the facility, it struggled to find enough adequately trained staff.
A number of senior Commonwealth public servants in Canberra, none of whom had set foot in St Basil's, were making decisions on 21 July 2020 about the residents in the teeth of very clear warnings from doctors.
The inquest is set to run for 5 weeks. Gloria Claish, SBS World News.